Hi everyone, my name is Maren Madry. I live here in beautiful Charlottesville, Virginia with my husband Travis and our adorable puppy Keen, who you might be hearing in this video because he's not taking his nap like he's supposed to right now. So welcome to our first video, I hope of several. This idea is kind of an experiment. We're gonna see how it goes. What I'd like to do is release one video a week. The purpose being I'd like to give families and kids especially an opportunity to still be doing music even though they're out of school during this nutty time. But bonus, I would love it to be a time for family to be together. A time of constructive and instructive, intentional time, not just sitting around staring at each other or annoying each other. So that's what I hope for this time, that it'd be just fun. We can learn a song together, pick up a few things about music along the way. So a little bit about me. I graduated with my bachelor's in music from Oklahoma City University, and then I went on to get my master's in music at Manhattan School of Music. And I've been very blessed to have a really vibrant, fun career as an opera singer, and it's been great. I love it. Right now is a crazy time because all of our gigs are canceled. But I will say that I feel very lucky to have that career, and it's been a lot of fun. But on the side, or in addition, I also teach private voice, and I recently, in the last few years, have developed a whole new side of my career, which has been program development, music program development for kids. I love kids. I really think that music, whether those kids grow up to be professional musicians or not, that to me is not the issue. It's a great tool to teach kids confidence. Also, music is a skill that, if cultivated, can be a fun, joyful thing for their whole lives, whether it's professional or not. I'm just a big believer in music in kids' lives. So that brings us to this video. So what I hope to do, as I said earlier, is to teach you, and hopefully your whole family is joining in, one song a week. And this week I've picked something pretty simple, I think, that we can go through for this time. And along the way, I'll also be explaining some things, some terms I'm using about music. I've tried to make this really broad in both age group and also musical skill. So it might seem that I'm over-explaining some things, but that's because I know that there'll be some people who are watching this who might have no musical skills and may not know what I'm talking about. So for those who are musically inclined, thank you for your patience in advance as we go through some of those things. So we're gonna jump in. This week we are learning well, at least for me, it was a camp classic. Maybe you grew up with it. It was written in the 70s. This would be Lean On Me by Bill Withers. So this is something I sing in camp all the time. I would think that many of you out there already know this tune. So it should be an easy one to learn together and a lot of fun to sing together today. So before we get to learning the song, I'd like to go through some vocal warm-ups. That's what I do with my private voice students. It's what I do in the programs that I've been doing. It's a way for you to learn about your voice and how the voice works best. And it's also a way to set you up for success when you sing on your own. Some people think that you can just, you know, have the talent to sing and you can just do it. It's there or it's not there. I think that there is natural talent for sure, but actually I'm more of a believer in learning a really solid technique and that being the basis of great singing. So whether you feel that you're naturally inclined or not, I do think most of it can be taught. So technique for me has three tiers. We start with breathing. It's the fuel for singing. It's impossible without it. And then I also work on tension, and we'll talk about each of these things a little bit more in just a second. Tension in the body can inhibit great singing. For singers, generally, tension is happening in your neck, jaw, or in your tongue. We'll talk more about that. And then the last tier of great technique that I work through in our warming up is clarity and resonance work. So what I mean by that is whatever is coming out of your mouth, it needs to be clear and resonant. Resonance is the air bouncing around inside our body to create a fuller and clearer sound. That's what resonance is. And it takes work to get there. So let's start with breathing. So during this video, I should mention there are links to the music that we're going to be singing, and I'm going to invite you to pause the video several times so that you can do things like pull up the music and also practice together as a family. I'm going to be like moving through in the video, so please pause as often as you need to kind of catch up or whatever you need. I will prompt you occasionally to go ahead and pause. So before we get to the song is when I'll tell you to pause and you can download the music. I've already paid for the rights for this music, so you don't have to do that. I just ask that you don't share the music outside of our class and outside of your family, since I've already paid for those rights for us to sing that song today. So getting back to technique, we are going to just learn a little bit about breathing first. So I'm going to pose a question, and you can pause the video, and you can take a poll with your family of who guesses what, and then I'll tell you the answer. So who thinks that correct breathing is coming from your low belly? When you breathe in and your belly puffs out, is that correct breathing? Or is correct breathing when you breathe up here in your chest? All right, you can pause the video and take a poll and see who guesses what, and then you can come back and I will tell you the answer. Okay, so the answer is low belly breathing. That's where we want to breathe when we sing, and I'll tell you why. So I think most of us feel like the chest makes sense. That's what we do in the doctor's office when they put the stethoscope. Ooh, that's hard to say. And they're listening to our heart and they ask us to breathe. They're listening to our lungs, and you puff out. That seems to make sense. Actually, look what happens when I do that. You can see like my shoulders are up, my neck is tight, my chest is tight, I'm pulling across. That doesn't make for very easy singing. That's part of the tension work that we'll talk about in a little bit. It makes you tight. And so a low belly breath, if anyone's done yoga, they talk about a low belly breath all the time. That's the kind of breath that's going to fuel and come out your vocal cords in a really consistent way. And you have more air when you do it that way. You have this big reservoir that you can fill down here, and this, not so much. So speaking of the vocal cords, here's some fun facts for you. Your vocal cords, they live right here inside your neck, inside a part of your body called the larynx. I wish I had visuals for you. Maybe I could put some pictures up. So your larynx, and then inside the very top are your vocal cords. Your vocal folds or vocal cords are these two ligaments that sit right together, and they open when you breathe, and then they close when you start to make sound, and they rub together. And so the combination of your air and the movement and the vibration of your vocal cords creates your sound, both speaking and especially singing. So that's a fun little fact for you right there of how your voice is actually working. So breathing. This week, I'm going to keep it really simple. We're just going to practice a low belly breath together. And in future lessons, I'll go a little more in depth of some exercises I can give you to practice that kind of breath. But for now, we're just going to get the idea. So when I was younger, the visualization that a teacher gave me was that I'm filling an inner tube around my waist. So imagine there's a deflated inner tube all the way around your waist, and as you breathe in, you are actually puffing out that inner tube. And then when you breathe out, it deflates again. So put your hand on your belly. We're actually using our diaphragm. Here's another fun fact for you. We're using our diaphragm to take these low belly breaths. It's a muscle that's right below your belly button. So find your belly button. Right below that is your diaphragm. It's a muscle. It's the muscle that twitches when you get hiccups. that's that muscle. And it's the one that's releasing and helping us take a really low, full breath and get all that air in there. So put your hand right underneath your belly button and take a breath in and feel everything kind of puff out. It's counterintuitive. We say breathe in, but we're not pulling in. We're actually releasing our bellies out. So breathe in and feel it puff out. And then breathe out and feel it being pulled back towards your spine. Breathe in again. And then breathe out. And you can feel your belly button being pulled back to your spine. So do that one more time. Imagine you're filling up the inner tube as you breathe in. And then you breathe out and it deflates. Very good. If you want, you can pause the video here and keep practicing together on that exercise. Next, we're going to talk about tension. So as I mentioned before, you can have tension in three primary places, usually, as a singer: your neck, your jaw, and your tongue. So your neck, that sometimes shows up whenever we think that we're reaching or helping ourselves by getting to a note, we're doing this. Your brain is so crazy. It tells our body things all the time, and it thinks that it's helping. That's what's happening. Your brain is just giving the signal to your neck, like, oh, we need to help her get to that note by reaching up. And it's not helping. It's actually making it way harder. That's an example of neck tension. For our jaw, as English speakers, English is one of those languages, it's not super smooth. We are chewing on our words all the time, so our jaw is very active. And when we sing, we want to minimize that activity and we want to keep it a lot smoother. It just makes our singing sound clearer, smoother, more musical. And so we work on not clenching our jaw. Also, sometimes if we're hitting a high note or a note that is big and belty, we'll want to kind of stick our jaw into it to try to like help hold the note. Again, doesn't help us at all. It actually makes it harder. And then for our tongue, that's the hardest one. It's the most elusive tension thing to work out. And so today I'm going to give us a tongue exercise to kind of loosen up our tongues. The tongue will get in the way in our language while we're speaking. It'll start to, sometimes while we're singing, push back to the back of our throat and literally sound can't get out. Again, it's our brain telling our tongue, oh, you're helping the person sing, and it's not. So we've got to work really hard, and there's lots of exercises you can do to try to retrain the tongue to stay out of our way. Your tongue is a big muscle. It goes all the way down to this base part of your throat. So it's hard to control. So we're going to do a fun exercise that I really love. It's called a tongue trill. If you're not able to do it, just keep practicing. I've seen plenty of students eventually accomplish the tongue trill. I will give you a secondary thing to do if you can't do the tongue trill. And it looks like this. That's it. Like you're sticking your tongue out at your annoying little brother and you're just making a funny noise with your tongue. So what's happening is you're sticking your tongue out, there's pressure with your lips around your tongue, and then you're passing air over your tongue to make the flutter. Y'all try that. Ready? Okay, great. While we do this exercise, to spare your family members from getting spit all over them, you can put your spit guard up so you're not spitting on people. That's an important thing probably during this time for all of us, not to spit on each other. So we're going to do it to a little exercise going up just about an octave on the piano. For those who don't know, an octave is 8 notes. So what we're going to do first, if you need to pause and work and try out the tongue trill on your own without any tune to it, you go ahead and pause and do that. I said I'd give you an alternative. If you can't do that, but you can roll your R's, that's another tongue release exercise. So if you can do that, but you can't do the other one, or one or the other is easier for you, you can do that one. Again, feel free to pause and practice that with each other. And we're gonna move on and put it to music. So we're just gonna use a little vocalese here. Vocalese is just a simple set of notes that we're using to warm up our voices. So it's gonna go like this. And then we're gonna move up a half So what we're going to do is I'm going to demonstrate first, and then I'm going to say your turn, and then together we're going to start going up the scale here, okay? So me first, I'm going to demonstrate the exercise again, and of course you're always welcome to rewind this and listen again if you need some more time or to pause, but it goes like this. All right, let's do it together. That's as high as we're going to go. For any older gentlemen who are watching this, maybe the dads who are watching this video, if you find that we're going too high, just drop out. No reason to strain your voices. We can also work down lower later. So that's the exercise I'm going to give you for tension today. Feel free to pause the video and keep working on that if you want with your family, or we'll move on. Okay. So we are going to move on to clarity and resonance work in our warm-up. As I mentioned before, clarity is about the vowels that we're using. The vowels are the, you know, they're the motion to what we're singing. They're carrying us through. The consonants are just helping us understand what word we're saying, but they're very short and not the most important part. What we really want to focus on while we're singing are the clarity of the vowels. And when I say clarity, I mean that we are creating a space inside of our mechanism. And when I say mechanism, I'm talking about like our face. Our face, our skull, like there's all these like bouncy areas for air to resonate in inside of our faces. Our sinus cavity that runs right here, that is a really great resonator. So we wanna set ourselves up for a place while we're singing that's tall and lengthy, and the vowels are just coming out in the same place every time. I probably sound like I'm talking crazy talk. The more you watch these videos, the more I'll be able to explain what I mean by tall vowels and lengthy vowels. Best example I can give you, or most simplistic example I can give you, is that if our mouths are really closed while we're singing, you just can't hear me, right? Our mouths are really closed. So there's not any tallness going on. And literally sound can't get out because my mouth is closed. So when we sing, we want our mouths to be nice and open, and we have all this space on the inside of our mouths that feels tall and vaulted. That is a place where we're creating space for the sound to bounce and resonate. And we're also, getting the sound out of our bodies. It's pinging right out rather than sitting in the back of our throats like, oh, that's when our tongue is in the way and everything's sitting in the back, and we don't want that. So does everyone know their vowels? Yes? Ah, eh, e, o, u. Okay, that was in a very American way of saying my vowels. In fact, when we're singing, we want to keep them more like the Italians would say them. Ah, eh, e, o, u. Very proper, very lengthy, very tall. So if we're singing them American style, they're a little short and they're a little clipped, and it's not as pretty sounding in our singing. So there's all kinds of exercises I can give you for these things. For this week, we're gonna keep it really simple and just work on two vowels in a little scale. So we're gonna work on E first. And when we sing E, we don't want E, we don't want super spread. That puts pressure on your jaw and on your tongue. We want an open mouth. So everyone take a second to breathe in and open your mouth. Maybe put your finger on your chin. E. You can sigh that E sound. Ready? E. That's like a good segue from sighing the sound in that really heady space to translating it to singing. They're very similar, those two sounds. And what I'm doing with E, as you can see, is not E, it's not spread, it's still tall, and my mouth is very open while I'm saying it. And that's a good start for us. So So what we're going to do with the E vowel is we're going to go just like we did it with the tongue trill. E. And as you can hear, I'm kind of sliding through and connecting all those notes. And they're just three notes up and down. If you're more musically inclined, this would be do, mi, so, mi, do. So I'm going to demonstrate, and then it's your turn to hop in. So this is the demonstration. All right, your turn. Ready? Together. Good. Make sure you're doing that low belly breath through it. Inclined from a do to a so. Keep it very simple. We're just taking that bright, tall ah and sliding up and sliding right back down. And again, fill it up with all your air. Your air is supporting that sound. I'm going to demonstrate first. And now it's your turn. Ready? Breathe. Simple. As we get better and better at doing these warm-ups, we'll go through them more quickly, I promise, and I won't do so much talking. It's hard the first time because I have to explain, especially for people who haven't sung very much, maybe, or don't know a lot about music. So now we're going to get to the song. Yay! All right. So move some of these things out of the way. Lean on Me, camp classic. You might know all the call and response things from camp. Those are really fun. I'm just going to teach the melody of all of these parts. If you want, if you're musically inclined already and you want to throw some harmonies in there, fantastic. I'm not going to teach harmonies this week. I'm just going to teach the basic melody of all the sections of this song. This is a part where you can pause the video, and if you haven't already done so, you can see some links. Should be in the show note section. Some links to both the just the text, just the words and the order of the song. That's what we're going to be following. But I also am going to have a link for the sheet music on there. For those who don't know what sheet music is, it's the actual like notes on the page, all the piano accompaniment, the words, all of it. I'm not even using that today. I'm using a lead sheet with the text. I'm not the greatest pianist ever, so you're going to have to forgive me. I make a mistake. So yeah, I put the sheet music in there because I already bought it. I have the rights to it. So I'm happy to share it with you. Again, please just don't share it outside of your family since you haven't purchased it. And you can go ahead and pause and download and put it up in front of the family to look at together on a separate device. Or if you have a printer in your house, go ahead and take a moment to print it for your family. Again, we're going to be following the order that's on just the text page. And the sheet music has all the text and everything, but there's a couple sections that we're actually not doing that's on the sheet music. So it'll be easier to follow just the words. So I'll give you a chance now to go ahead and download that for yourselves. Okay, welcome back. All right, let's learn this song. Like I said before, it's probably one that you already know. You probably know this tune, but I'm going to start, as you can see on the text sheet, I'm going to call it the lead sheet. That's what it is for me, at least. I have the little chords written on top of each word. You're going to see that it's just two columns. We've got verse one, chorus, verse two, and then you're just going to see the written chorus. That means you just need to hop back to where all the words are for the chorus. I put it in bold on this sheet of paper so you know where to go back to each time. I just haven't written it out every single time. So if you see the word chorus as we go, that just means your eyes need to dart back to where the Lean On Me chorus starts. And then verse three, then another chorus. We're gonna sing this chorus a lot. And then the bridge. A bridge in a song it's exactly what it sounds like. It's a bridge between a verse and a chorus, or chorus and a chorus. So it's just a slightly different tune usually, and the words obviously are a little different, and it's kind of like building us up to get us excited to sing the chorus again. That's what a bridge is. So that's underneath, you see that, like what, third chorus? And then at the very end of the song, we're gonna sing the chorus twice, and then you're gonna see that last line I put there is called a tag. That's just kind of like a happy little button to end the piece. And what we're doing there is we're just going to re-sing that last line of the chorus. After we've already sung it twice, we're gonna sing Somebody to Lean On, but we're gonna do it nice and slow and drawn out just to kind of finish the song. Okay, so that's the order of the song. And now I'm just going to help you learn the tune for each section. So the verse tune, the chorus tune, and the bridge tune. All the verses, verse one, two, and three, it's all the same melody. So I'm not going to go through the three separate verses. It's the same melody for all three of those. Chorus, always the same text too. And then the bridge, of course. So let's do that now. All right, so look at the top of your page, verse one. I am going to play or sing the melody for you, okay? So first I'm just gonna sing verse one, just to kind of give you a taste.
Sometimes in our lives, we all have pain, we all have sorrow, but if we are wise, we know that there's always tomorrow.
Okay, that was a big piece to pull off for you right there, because I was playing all this accompaniment. The tune itself. That's through sorrow, from sometimes in our lives, we all have pain, we all have sorrow. So those are the notes for verse one. Best thing to do, I think, when you're learning a melody is to hum it first. So forget about the words and just hum through that tune with me. Ready? We're gonna hum it. Let's stop there. Always take it in chunks so you don't get overwhelmed. Let's just do that one more time together. Again, you're welcome to pause and rewind as many times as you want. I'm just gonna do it one more time for us, okay? Great, you've got the first three lines. Again, pause if you need to and keep doing it over and over again if you're not there. I'm gonna continue going on from But If We Are Wise, and we're humming. Ready? So as you can tell, the first verse, the two sections, are very similar sounding, and there's just a tiny bit of a change on that last line. Instead of da 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 da, we have da 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 da. All right, we're gonna hum the whole verse together. Ready? Take a breath. Great. I always feel that the next step is to put a little more sound to it. Now that we've hummed it, let's do la la la. That's an easy one. Ready? I'll demonstrate first what it's gonna sound like. La 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 la. All right, so that's what we're doing. We're just kind of putting la throughout there. Ready? Breathe.
La 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 la.
We've lawed it. Now we're just waiting on the words, but we want to make sure we have the rhythm, okay? So for those of you who are haven't done a lot of music, rhythm is the current underneath all the music. It's the beat. There's the beat that we're keeping tempo to. Tempo means like how fast or slow we're doing it. And so if it was right, that would be a faster tempo, or if it was, that would be a slower tempo. So we have that underlying beat, and then we have the rhythm of where the words fit in. So there's like that, right? The main big beat. And then we have the words that fit in. Here we go. I'm gonna demonstrate.
Sometimes in our lives, we all have pain. We all have sorrow. But if we are wise, we know that there's always tomorrow.
All right, so I for some reason didn't clap through tomorrow, but I think you get the idea. So I'm going to do that again with you, and then feel free to pause the video and keep rewinding and practicing that so you feel that you've got the rhythm of the piece. If you are reading the sheet music, you can see all the rhythm for every note. I don't want to dive into that this week. It's going to be a little overwhelming for those of you who maybe haven't done a lot of music for me to describe every single quarter note and half note. And yeah, so we're not going to do that this week. But for those of you who are musically inclined and really want to see the rhythm specifically, it is on the sheet music. Okay, so we're going to do that one more time. Okay, get the beat going. Ready? We're taking it a little slower than normal right now, just so we can get it in our heads.
Sometimes in our lives, we all have pain. We all have sorrow. But if we are wise, we know that there's always tomorrow.
All right, so pause the video if you need to and go ahead and work on that on your own, and then we're going to continue on with the chorus. Actually, I lied. We're not going to work on the chorus yet. We're going to put that whole verse together with the words. Okay, so while we were clapping out the rhythm, we were practicing singing the words in the right spot. So now we're going to put it all together. The melody and the rhythm and the words. Ready? Here we go.
Sometimes in our lives, we all have pain. We all have sorrow. But if we
time, but we're going to pick up the tempo a little bit. Means we're going to go a little faster. So instead of going, we're going to go,
sometimes in our lives, we all have pain, we all have sorrow.
All right, so just a little faster. Ready? One, two, ready, go.
Sometimes in our lives, we all have pain, we all have sorrow, but if we are wise, we know that there's always tomorrow.
Yay, good job. All right, now we're gonna learn the chorus. You're gonna sing this chorus a lot, so this is an important one. I'm gonna sing it for you first with all the fun bells and whistles and me playing along for myself. And then we're going to break it down just like we did for the verses, okay? So actually it comes right out of the verse. So if you go, always tomorrow, lean on me when you're not strong, and I'll be your friend. I'll help you.
It 1,000 times, but let's break it down now to just the notes. I hope I remember them all. So lean on me when you're not strong, and I'll be your friend. I'll help you carry on, for it won't be long till I'm gonna need somebody to
just the notes broken down for you. Again, feel free to rewind this and listen to it a few times if you need. But because I think most of you are familiar with this song, I'm going to press on. If you're not, pause, rewind, listen to it again. Now we're going to do the humming, okay? So I'll play along. We're starting here. This is an E. All right, so we're going to hum. Again, pause, rewind, hum it for yourself a few times if you need to. I'm gonna press on with the laws, all right? Here we go for the laws. Ready? And
la, 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 la.
I messed up that note again. I don't know what's going on with that. But again, I sang it right, so I think you got it. Okay. Again, pause, rewind if you need to, on la. I'm gonna move on and we are going to do rhythm first and then we're gonna put the words together, okay? So the chorus is always coming right out of a verse. So we're gonna start a little bit back. We're gonna start the claps on, but if we are wise, we know that there's always tomorrow, just a few lines before the chorus in verse one. So.
But if we are wise, we know that there's always tomorrow. Lean on me when you're not strong, and I'll be your friend. I'll help you.
Rewind, go through that rhythm for yourselves. I'm going to continue on for those who are ready with putting it together with piano and notes and rhythm all together. Here's your starting pitch. And you hear, like, right before we're getting into it with always tomorrow, lean on me when you're not strong, and I'll be your friend. I'll help you carry on, for it won't be long till I'm gonna need somebody to lean on. Woo! We did it. That's the chorus, and we're gonna sing it again and again and again. So if you need some more time, pause, rewind, and listen to it again, okay? And then I'm gonna move on to verse, or not the verse, for the bridge. Okay, so for the bridge, there's not a lot of piano accompaniment. It's kind of like this fun, jazzy section, I guess. So I'm gonna play it for you first so you can just hear it, how it all sounds together, and then we'll break it down as we always do, all right? So we're coming right out of a chorus. Somebody to lean on. So just call on me, brother, when you need a hand. We all need somebody to lean on. I just might have a problem that you'd understand. We all need somebody to lean on. Lean on me. And then we go back into a chorus. Okay, cool. So that's the bridge. Pretty simple. I'm going to... Oh man, I didn't actually think about practicing these particular on the piano. I'm gonna sing it for you. I told you I wasn't a great pianist. Okay. Starting low. So just call on me, brother, when you need a hand. We all need somebody to lean on. Same tune now. I just might have a problem that you'd understand. We all need somebody to lean on. All right, those are the notes playing by themselves. Again, I apologize, I forgot to practice playing along, just the notes for those. Okay, so now we're gonna break it down like we do with humming first, okay? It's low, it's a low section. If you need to talk it, like speak it out, that's acceptable. It's low for me too. All right, that's where we're starting, so we're gonna hum. Coming. I didn't break it down into sections because really it's just call and response, which means it's one melody calling to a next melody, and then it repeats again, that same melody calling to the next melody. I don't know if you noticed that, but the first line and the second line are the same as the third and fourth. Okay, so again, pause, rewind, listen to it on humming only if you need to. I'm going to move on with la. And again, I'm not gonna break it into chunks this time like I did with verse one, because it's really the same tune for the whole thing. So we're gonna put some la's in there. Ready? One, two, ready, go. La la la, la 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 la, la 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 la, la 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 la, la la la, la 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 la. Repeat. La la la, la 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 la. La 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 la. Okay, so we've now done the laws. You can repeat that for yourself if you'd like. We're gonna put the words in. Or just kidding, we're gonna make sure we know the rhythm first. So this is coming, it's sandwiched between two choruses. So we're coming out of a chorus, we go into the bridge, and then as soon as we finish the bridge, we go right back into the chorus. And that's how we're finishing the song. We sing the chorus twice, and that last line of the chorus twice, the tag. to end the piece. So we're almost there. Woo! Okay, so here we are again, clapping out the rhythm and fitting in the words, okay? This is the big beat. And we're finishing the chorus to get into the bridge.
Somebody to lean on, so just call on me, brother, when you need a hand. We all need somebody to lean on. I just might have a problem that you'd understand. We all need somebody to lean on me.
And then we're back into the chorus. See how that works? Sandwiched in there. It's the bridge, bridging the two choruses. Okay. So again, rewind for yourself if you need, but I'm going to put it together now with the chords. So I'm going to take you from the end of the chorus to get into the bridge to start the chorus again. I won't do the whole thing, just to give you an idea of how that flows. And then we're going to sing the whole thing. Okay. So we're going to start at the very end of the chorus, somebody to lean on to get into the bridge.
Somebody to lean on, so just call on your brother when you need a hand. We all need somebody to lean on. I just might have a problem that you'd understand. We all need somebody to lean on me when you're not strong. Da, 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 da.
Okay, cool. So repeat that for yourself if you need to and practice that with your family. But I think we're ready to put the whole order together and just feel it out. So what we're gonna do is I'm gonna take a pause right here for those who do wanna go back and work on it. And then when we come back, we're gonna go through the whole thing. Okay, so let's try this whole song out. We have learned the melody of the verses. We haven't spoken all the words at each verse, so it's gonna be the same melody for verse 1, 2, and 3. Just know that as we go through it here, you're gonna follow the order that I have printed for you, okay? So verse 1, chorus. Verse 2, different words, same melody, so don't get too tripped up on that. Same rhythm, all of that. Then we sing another chorus, as you can see on the top of the page, the next column over. Sing another chorus. Then we're gonna sing verse 3. Again, same melody, same rhythm as the first verse that you learned, just different words. Then we're singing another chorus. And then after that chorus, we're getting into the bridge. Then after the bridge, we're getting into the end of the song, which is two choruses, two times in a row. And on that second time in a row, we're gonna repeat that last line of somebody to lean on, the first time in a regular, normal rhythm. And then the tag, we're going to draw it out.
Somebody to lean on.
Just to give it a nice button to finish the piece. Okay, are you ready? All that work, now we're gonna put it together. So I'm gonna sing it through all the way, the whole song. Join with me if you need at the end to pause and try it a few times. Great. And then what's going to be fun is I'm not going to sing at all that next time, and I'm just going to play along and mouth for you so you know where we are in the music. And then you get to sing it all by yourself, for each other, individually, or all as a big group. It's kind of like your karaoke track to do it all by yourself. All right? So all together first. Count us in. One, two, ready, breathe.
Sometimes in our lives, we all have pain. We all have sorrow. But if we are wise, we know that there's always tomorrow. Lean on me.
Swallow your pride. If I have things you need to.
need a hand. We all need somebody to lean on. I just might have a problem that you'd understand. We all need somebody to lean on. Lean on me when you're not strong, and I'll be your friend. I'll help you.
I'm going to go ahead and play the next portion, which is just the accompaniment. Just me playing and me mouthing along so you know where we are if you get lost. And we're going to do that next, but I'm going to give you an opportunity to pause and practice if you want. So here we are. You get to do it all by yourself without me helping you, except for mouthing it, just in case you get lost in the order of the song. And this is your big time to shine. I think what's really fun about this song that I chose this week is that it really pertains to the time that we're in right now. We're in a crazy time, this pandemic, and we need to lean on each other. I don't want to be corny, but it really does apply. That verse about if you have things you need to borrow, you know, like toilet paper or Clorox wipes, that gets me. It gets me. All right, so I'm going to play along. And not sing so that you get to have kind of a karaoke track, do it all by yourself. Again, if you want to do this individually, one at a time for each other, that's super fun. Or if you want to do it all as a group, that's great too. I encourage you after this time is over to take this music and Zoom your friends and Zoom your family members, sing it for them. Put on a little performance. We need a little music right now. So here we go, it's happening. I'm gonna count you in. So you know when we're about to start, I'm going to say 1, 2, 3, 4, some, and that's your cue to go. I'll give you maybe like a 1, 2, ready, go, some. I'll give you a little point. How about that? All right, here it is. Thank you. badly I could hear you. It's so sad that I don't get to. If you're bold and you want to film your family singing the song and send it to me, that'd be so cool. We did it. That was the first video, I hope, of many. I hope I keep putting these out. I can put these out during this time, I guess, until it's over. I don't know. So you guys, thanks for joining me. Thanks for having fun with me and learning a song together. So I just ask that those who can, who feel financially that they can, you can see my Venmo handle right here. I just ask that you send me a donation of some kind so I can continue doing these videos. They aren't free to make. I have to buy the music and yada, yada, yada. So so if you can do that, my suggested donation is like 10 bucks or whatever you feel comfortable doing. And for those of you who financially just don't feel that you're able to do that right now, this is a gift to you. Please feel no pressure to do that. I want it to be available for everyone, which is why I chose to do it in this way. So also, please share this video and encourage other families that you think might enjoy this to do it. I think it's going to be really fun if you play this in the background, that track in the background, and you sing it for some friends over a Zoom hangout. I think that's so fun. I encourage you to do that. And I encourage you to check out another video in another week. I'll put something else out. Please, in messages, or I'll put my email in this video, send me song suggestions. They need to be family friendly, so keep it PG. But I'm happy to do any kind of mainstream song that you are wanting to do, especially if I get a lot of the same request. I'll get the music for that and learn it, and we can learn it and do it all together. Yeah, this was really fun. Thanks so much for joining me, and I hope to see you soon. Stay healthy, stay well, and spread the joy of music this week. Bye.